So first of all, I just want to welcome Marianne Thomas. Marianne is the Parliamentary Secretary for Health, and it's a very great pleasure to have you here, Marianne. Thank you very much for attending. I'm just going to say a few things about Marianne and introduce her. She grew up in a small farming community in northeastern Victoria, and so she understands the unique needs of people living in small towns and communities outside of the major metropolitan areas. And she believes that government has an important role to play in supporting access to first-rate health services, which is, of course, what all of you provide. She's interested in education and job opportunities for all Victorians, no matter where they live. She's particularly passionate about the needs of growing families and the services and infrastructure they need to thrive. So we're very much looking forward to Marianne's presentation. And just before I ask you to welcome Marianne, she'll be joining a panel which will have Dr. Deb Cole, Daryl Annett, Professor Hani Kalash and Ingrid Ozzles as well on the panel after Marianne's presentation. I might just say a couple of quick words just to introduce everybody who'll be on that panel so we can go smoothly into it. Deb Cole is the Chief Executive Officer of Dental Health Services Victoria. Welcome, Deb. Thank you for attending. And she was appointed in 2011. She's had a wonderful career in local government and in healthcare. She's been in senior roles and she's had very extensive experience both here and interstate. And Daryl Annett, you've already introduced. He's already introduced that, of course. He works at the Salvation Army Urban Justice Centre. Professor Hani Kalash is Director of Clinical Leadership and Education Research at also Dental Health Services Victoria. Since February 2005, Professor Kalash has contributed the clinical experience to DHSV and has undertaken many research projects to improve the state of public oral health sector. Thank you, Hani, for joining us today. And Ingrid Ozzles is an active workplace mental health and suicide prevention advocate and an educator for more than 16 years, and she's the founder and managing director of Mental Health at Work, a national consultancy aimed at improving the mental health resilience and productivity of organisations and their people. So now please join me in welcoming Marianne Thomas.
Thanks very much, Demos, and thank you everyone for the opportunity to join with you on this Friday evening. You're all looking still remarkably fresh, so congratulations to you. I'll try not to talk at you for too long. May I begin by acknowledging the traditional owners of the land on which we meet and pay my respects to their elders past and present. It's my pleasure to be here today as the Parliamentary Secretary for Health, representing the Minister for Health at the two-day oral health conference, Where the Mind Meets the Mouth, which has got to be one of the more interesting conference titles I've come across. And I'm delighted to see you've got a hashtag there. I'm a great tweeter, so I will be tweeting some of my comments here to you this evening. Can I also acknowledge and thank Demos for inviting me here today as the Chief Executive Officer of the North Richmond Community Health. And Deborah Cole, Chief Executive Officer, Dental Health Services Victoria. I understand also that my colleague and friend, the local member, Richard Wynne, was with you earlier today. Thank you again to North Richmond Community Health Service for inviting me to this conference. It is a fantastic opportunity for all of you, oral health clinicians and experts in your field, to come together to discuss the best ways to work with your patients and help achieve behaviour changes which benefit their oral and general health. The Andrews Labor Government is committed to improving oral health for all Victorians and is investing over $207 million in the 2015-16 Dental Health Program. This investment will provide dental treatment to over 332,000 eligible clients. I'm very proud of our government's investment in public dental services. We want to ensure that Victorians, particularly those on low incomes and those who are disadvantaged, can access the dental health care they need in a timely way. And this means having a dental health program that provides the best evidence-based care, is person-centred and is effective. Maintaining good oral health is the foundation of all good health and well-being, and it is central to achieving good patient outcomes for everyone. The costs and burden associated with poor oral health are well known, and we all know, I know that you definitely know, that oral disease is a key marker of disadvantage in our society. Those who experience the poorest oral health are people living in rural areas, those on low incomes, dependent older people, Aboriginal people, people with a disability, and people from culturally and linguistically diverse backgrounds, many of whom walk through the doors of North Richmond Community Health every single day. We know that dental conditions are the highest cause of all preventable hospitalisations for Victorians under 25 years of age and the second highest for all ages. And I might say that I very much doubt that that is a data point that's well understood in our community. I think it is something that we need to talk much more about, and we need our community more broadly to understand this real burden on our system, and of course on the individuals who are having these poor oral health outcomes. So we know, of course, that improving oral health requires and needs access to fluoride in water and in toothpaste. Alarmingly, in some parts of our state, and indeed in regional areas, we're still having some of these debates about fluoride in water. But good dental hygiene and regular access to preventative dental care is, of course, also of primary importance. Good oral health is also very much about the food we eat. And over the past couple of months, I've been very happy to be involved in promoting a couple of healthy eating initiatives, including the Live Lighter campaign, an initiative of the Cancer Council and the Heart Foundation, and of course the government. And this year's focus is on sugary drinks. Now, as you will all know, not only will a can of soft drink a day, and alarmingly, there are so many people, including young children, who do consume a can of soft drink a day, not only will it add 6 kilograms a year to your weight, but soft drinks, sports drinks and juices are leading causes of tooth decay. And you will also know that while diet drinks might spare you the extra kilojoules, my understanding is, of course, that they are equally damaging to your teeth. Again, really important preventative health messages that we need to get out into our community. This conference's theme of mindfulness and how it can be applied to person-centred care is timely. Our government is working hard to provide a Victorian health system that meets the needs and values all Victorians, no matter where they work or live. Victorians deserve a health system that will improve the outcomes and experience of every person at every place and at every time they come into contact with it. Person-centred care means a health system that meets the need of the people it exists to serve. It enables choice, a positive experience, and individual participation in health and treatment. Achieving person-centred care involves consciously and deliberately redesigning the health system. By working together, we will be able to achieve this and build a stronger health system for Victoria today and for the years ahead. I would like to thank the North Richmond Community Health Service for their outstanding work in providing public dental services in Victoria and for organising this conference. Thank you so much for having me here today. It's my pleasure to be with you. And on behalf of the government, can I thank each and every one of you for the work that you do every single day in helping to improve the health and well-being of Victorians. Thank you.